Hello and welcome to EQ International Magazine, India's oldest and leading solar media. And today we have Mr. Abhijit Sinha with us from National Program Director from Ease of Doing Business. A very warm welcome to EQ, sir.
Thank you.
Sir, आप मुझे थोड़ा सा बताएंगे कि हमारे क्या अपकमिंग प्रोजेक्ट्स हैं इन दी इलेक्ट्रिक व्हीकल्स एंड मोबिलिटी.
नेशनल हाईवे फॉर इलेक्ट्रिकल व्हीकल इज ई मोबिलिटी पार्टनर फॉर रिन्यूएबल एनर्जी 2021. We are trying to provide vehicle to as much as possible to our delegates, to our national and international representatives, to go back to their airports and their hotels and to come in the morning to attend this expo. This initiative is an alternative initiative to counter and show the commitment of Renewable Energy India Expo towards clean and green energy.
Anything new we are up to see for 2022, anything new technology that is upcoming?
COVID has hit renewable energy and many other sectors very bad. This year, the new thing, if you ask me, I'll say Ease of Doing Business as an official facilitator would take care, would try to work hand in hand with people with recommendations and prescriptions which we are getting from the industry related to policy discussion to an extent, and mostly we focus on the technological advancement. So renewable energy, wind energy, solar, these all energies are evolving every day, and these energies are very important for model RFP and from the perspective of commercialization, from the perspective of scale up. So Ease of Doing Business, being an official facilitator, is first time in 2021 facilitating Renewable Energy India, and we look forward to get a lot of recommendation and lot of prescription from industry to take forward with Renewable Energy Ministry and many other relevant ministries.
And as you know, the government has set few targets for the solar industry especially. So how Ease of Doing Business is helping out the manufacturers and all, regarding the policies and all?
See, 1.5 years we have spent with this bad hit of COVID, and now we are back in action. Now Renewable Energy India has brought all stakeholders together, and they are going to talk, they are going to discuss their new norms of how to do business. And obviously, COVID has changed business economics and business dynamics for everyone. So a lot of new thing which has came up, our thought process is to align with them, to make them comfortable, provide them ease to do their business. And if to a certain extent they need technical support, they need certification, they need classification, they need certain type of approvals or permissions, wish to create a single window clearance for installation. If there is a commercial problem, yesterday we were into CEO roundtable, there were a lot of discussion happened regarding difficulties which renewable energy as a sector is going through. So we wish to, if not in one shot, it's just a start after COVID, but definitely in coming days and coming months, we'll be able to start from a place and we'll be able to take this up as a very progressive pilot to support renewable energy sector with perfect and on-ground actual ease of doing business.
And what's your view on the the market, the Indian solar market? There are many challenges and opportunities as well, as now international brands are not participating. So how it will be for the Indian manufacturers?
A long list of issues, long list of tariff issues, long list of coordination issues, long list of problems with bureaucracy, long list of overpower cross domain sectors, from the DISCOM, from the renewable energy sector, and then from wind energy. These all need to kept together in an design, in a framework. Then we'll be able to understand and give an actual perspective. A lot of people in roundtable, in Ease of Doing Business programs, they say the policies which come on ground actually are not in line with the vision which top leadership has and industry require. It happens because these policies are coming from people who have worked into different domain. We need domain experts, we need federations and industry bodies to come together, come forward and design their own prototypes. And it is only possible when you conduct pilots, when you put all these things together and at least you try to do something on ground instead of doing a lot of discussion over the webinar and seminar, policy and survey. So that is what ease of doing business we do. We conduct pilots. If it is a permission issue, if it is a finance issue, we try to solve it, and then we give that RFP, give that process to people who are, you know, state governments. They can take it up and take this forward for a scale up.
And if you talk about electric vehicles, so like, what's the distribution plans like for in which all states we can see this facility?
Electric vehicle and renewable energy, they to a point, to an extent, they marry each other very well. We'll have to understand how sooner and how, you know, smoothly we can arrange this arranged marriage. We know electric mobility will only be in true sense if it is powered by a renewable source. Otherwise, burning diesel into a car or burning coal into a power plant, both are to the climate is same thing. To make it possible, we should make all possible arrangements to match these framework together. And these frameworks are going to match only if we will conduct on-ground pilots. So National Highway EV has 20 charging stations. Out of 20, as of now, with support of renewable energy, we'll be able to make two stations renewable powered. They will not be connected. They will not be drawing power from the thermal grids. I want more. 18 highways are coming up after this pilot. I want more station to come as renewable power station and less station on the conventional grid.
As you know, like, the petrol and diesel prices are going high day by day. So like, by when everyone is waiting, like, to it's going to be, you know, very much easy for everyone to go for the electric vehicles and all. So by when it will come in process and in a flow? Like, everyone, we can see on the roads, everyone is into the, like, you know, leaving petrol cars and diesels and going for electric vehicles.
Esha, we have different countries on globe, and every country has its own rate of adoption. India has its own rate of adoption. Problem to me, what it looks like, is I don't know the rate of adoption. You don't know the rate of adoption. This, the one reason which I see very clearly and very, you know, upfront is, you have COVID dashboards in India. How many people infected, how many people died, how many people are, you know, recovered, and how many people today tested negative. It is visible. You can compare your country with Algeria and Israel and Australia. But when it comes to electric vehicle, you don't have a national dashboard. First thing which India should have very quickly, very soon, is a national dashboard which speaks what is the rate of adoption today, where we were last year, and on what rate we are growing. If you will have that trajectory, you will be able to understand what we speak, what I speak. Yes, yes. What I speak or what you speak is going to take us ease of doing business and electric mobility in 2050. But we may assume a wrong date by 2030, 2032. That factual, you know, disconnect is very, very, you know, discomfortable. I have proposed a national electric vehicle registration system, national EVRS, for charger and electric vehicles separately with Ministry of IT. It is still under progress. It is still under consideration to be piloted on National Highway EV. It will give a very important, dashboard for nation to know how many EV we registered today, how many we registered last month, and on this speed, if you change a policy, it reflects on that. On this speed, you are going to become at 20% or 50% EV by 2030 or 2040. It should be visible in the trajectory. It should not be like somebody wake up and says, okay, we will be 20% EV next year or after 3 years. After 3 years, he says, it did not work the way we thought, so we'll again after. These things give negative publicity. These things give, you know, market or false hope. This should not happen.
Thank you so much, sir. Thanks a lot for being with us.
Pleasure to be with you, and all the best for your ventures and for your interviews in Renewable Energy India Expo. I wish many compliments to EQ for conducting very good seminar and webinars. And it's my pleasure to be in an interaction with you, Isa. Thank you.
Thank you so much, sir. Thanks a lot.